Hey guys, welcome back to Wind Chaser. Figured I'd make another video. We're in the first growth stage of our crops. Updated all of the fields. Basically what we're gonna end up doing is spraying herbicide over a lot of these fields to knock down some weeds. Well, not necessarily knock them down, but prevent them from growing. We broadcasted some lime over these fields, so they're a little bit on the basic side, which is fine. But we have our corn coming in. So what I'm going to do, it's 6 o'clock, the dealership's open. I'm going to go down here. I'm going to rent the 4440 Patriot. Yeah, we're gonna probably rent it for like 10 hours. Pretty big. Hit to the bank there. Apparently it only cost us 10,000 to rent that, which is weird. Anyways, here it is. Fire it up. And I think it's that one. Yeah, that's the ladder. So I'll just boogie on over to these tanks over here, fill up. If you guys have been following my Facebook page at all, you would know that I'm working on a John Deere 4045R sprayer. I just increased the wheels a little bit. I'm not really much of a Case fan, but I saw a few pictures and videos of 4440s, and I liked it. I liked the idea of using the quad track cap, and overall it's a pretty cool piece of machinery. We'll turn on our beacon lights as we're heading onto the road. We're gonna move down to field 37. We have Milo growing in this field. We're just gonna hit it with some herbicide A. For moisture, keep the weeds down. We've been really good at managing our weeds. We did pre-emerge herbicide, and then we're going to hit it again with another dose of herbicide. So it should turn out well. I updated this road here. That's why the car spline's a little bit off. I never adjusted the car spline since I kind of smoothed out this road and made it a little bit straighter. I also increased the growth period for alfalfa, so we're not cutting it every week, we're cutting it every 2 weeks. So since we're only in the second growth stage, we shouldn't be trampling our crops, I don't think. Yeah, it doesn't look like it. So we'll fold out our booms here. And load a GPS like this. Want it 36.5. Something like that works. Need to adjust that so I can use my mouse. Hide that HUD so it's out of the way. About time I made another video of this sprayer working. Foot booms. Usually I hire this out with Horseplay, but figured since I was making a video and it's been a while that I'd play a little bit. Usually what I do if I'm on the computer playing Farm Sim, I'm usually hiring out workers with Horseplay, and then I'm not actually playing, I'm doing modeling. Just because playing the game's a little boring. It gets boring after a while, but still nice to get stuff done with Horseplay, and you know, I'll hop on and I'll do some manual work for a little bit with GPS, like planting or plowing or spraying in this case, and but it takes a long time to get stuff done, so I hire out a lot of the work. So we're coming into kind of a awkward place here. Gotta raise our booms up. So I'm just putting down herbicide to basically balance out the pH, mostly. That's the primary reason. The next couple of growth cycles will do that as well, but this might be one of the first harvests where a lot of my fields are pretty close to being weed-free. So we'll see what the yields look like compared to the previous two seasons. And it's really amazing how much quicker spraying goes with a 120 foot boom in 1200 gallon tank. It's amazing, like, how much time you waste with the little 800 gallon tank and 90 foot booms. It's like you can't go very far until you have to refill again. So that was really the whole motivation behind making this. And then it's still pretty basic. I mean, the whole Patriot design is pretty basic compared to the John Deere. Some people might like the simplicity of it, but I like the idea of the John Deere. You can put, it's a front engine mount, so you can interchange the dry box and the sprayer. So that's the whole motivation behind making the John Deere. Plus, eventually I'm gonna be switching over to John Deere tractors and combines. So it'd be nice to have a nice sprayer to go along with that. But for now, I'm pretty happy with the 4440. So now we can kind of just focus on spraying our Milo. Can raise our boom as we're turning. Lower it back down. Hop in cab. A little bit quieter inside the cab. Nice view of the lake. I think what I might do is actually script in some hotkeys that will raise the booms and lower them, so I don't have to keep doing mouse control. I can just like hit a button and it will lift up both the booms as I'm coming into a turn and stuff like that. I think that would be a lot easier than try to manually lift them both as I'm coming out of a turn. Thank you. I don't think we'll be able to get this whole field done, but on one tank, we can try. It's not the end of the world. Herbicides are relatively inexpensive compared to things like seed and or like the double letter herbicides, which I don't really understand the point of that. It just does like more like longer days without weed germination, but I don't think it actually kills existing weeds. Set up for like 3 days of no weeds, it should really be like 15 days on this map. If you're gonna be spending that kind of money, it should really eliminate all the weeds. Guys, basically empty here. So we're done with that tank, we're gonna have to refill it. that is the Patriot